It is my pleasure to be here, and before we start, I would like to acknowledge the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, their members past and present. I would like to thank their elders for the safe custodianship of the lands upon which we are privileged to stand. When I started entering the small hallowed halls of Triple J way back in 1983, we could pick up a whole host of news sources in the print form. There was the Sun, the Mirror and the Telegraph. There was a morning, there was an evening paper. There was the Australian Financial Review, there was the Australian, and there was the Sydney Morning Herald. And in fact, we were enlightened into the world of corruption and satire through such publications as the National Times and the Bulletin. Those last two are no longer with us, and it seems as though the families of the Fairfaxes, the Packers, have faded from the media world. In fact, there's only one person left who controls so much of the media, and I just can't remember his name right now. In some cities, there is one outlet of news for the whole population. And yet, in the last few years, there has been this little course that has come up through the worldwide interweb. Yes, we have the web, we have the blog, we have Twitter and Instagram. But are they going to serve what the papers have done? Is Caxton Cactus newspaper Nullius? That is the question we'll address today, and what a panel we have. As you heard, Margot Saville, currently a freelancer, but a coup with the battle for Bennelong about Maxine McHugh's political coup. She's been a debater at university, so don't be intimidated by that. She has also been a lawyer. Do be intimidated by that. She entered journalism, has worked for The Australian, the ABC, Nine Network and the Sydney Morning Herald, and is here today. Please give her a round of applause. Don Groves has succumbed to the dark side and writes a weekly blog, no paper involved. But as you heard, he was the showbiz variety face for many years and currently has joined up as senior journo with the film and television magazine IF, and is also the Australian correspondent for the London-based C21 Media, Don Groves. Simon Thomson started his humble life in a kitchen. He then went off to run a regional newspaper and then made it to the Big Smoke, where he was a restaurant critic since four notches in his belt fewer. He was at the Sydney Morning Herald and the Daily Telegraph. He's edited six editions of the Sydney Morning Herald Good Food Guide. And nowadays he appears on my station, 70, well, it's not mine, it's yours, 702. He's appeared on MasterChef, but don't hold that against him, and he was a judge on Iron Chef Australia. He still writes about food and succumbs occasionally to blogging. Please welcome Simon Thomson. At Colvin, he delivered last year's Andrew Ollie lecture, has anchored the ABC's radio current affairs program PM. He's been a foreign correspondent, a local correspondent, and it's a pleasure to bring him here today. Mark Colvin, ladies and gentlemen. This is to be an incredibly strictly run debate. We are doing it on Sydney University rules. No, we're not. It's okay. Each member will have 3 minutes in which to espouse their views. Then we will take some questions from the audience, and I ask you to challenge or fan the flames that are raised here today. To get us off, we will have speaking in a toss of the coin. It was decided that Margot Saville and Mark Colvin are on one team, and they will debate for the argument. And then on the other side, Don Groves and Simon Thomson will debate against the argument. Would you like to nominate, please, your first speakers, ladies and gentlemen? Running out of the room, so Mark Colvin will speak first, Simon Thomson will speak first for his team. Don will go first. Sorry, I just wanted to pull the wool out of your wings there. Who will go first? Mark Colvin, will you please nominate heads or tails?
Heads.
I'm afraid it's tails. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome to the stage Don Groves.